सर इट इज सम टाइम नियरली 3 months सिंस आई हैड द अपॉर्चुनिटी ऑफ स्पीकिंग इन दिस हाउस एट लेंथ ऑन द प्रोविजंस ऑफ दिस बिल एज इट वॉज ओरिजिनली प्रजेंटेड टू द लोकसभा. हॉनरेबल मेम्बर्स मे रिकॉल द जनरल डिस्कशन ऑन द फ्लोर ऑफ द हाउस एंड द अप्रेजल विच वॉज गिवेन टू द बिल ड्यूरिंग द पीरियड दैट द बिल हैज बीन बिफोर द पार्लियामेंट इट हैज बीन सब्जेक्टेड टू अ वाइड वैरायटी ऑफ कमेंट्स बाई इंडिविजुअल्स एंड इंस्टीट्यूशंस representing various sets of opinion. These have all been taken into consideration and after due deliberations, certain amendments were proposed by the government. These have been considered and incorporated in the bill एज पास्ड बाई द लोकसभा. हॉनरेबल मेम्बर्स आर अनडाउटेडली अवेयर ऑफ द वेरियस प्रोविजन्स ऑफ द बिल एज ओरिजिनली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड. द प्रोविजन्स वर एक्सप्लेन्ड ब्रीफली इन द एक्सप्लेनेटरी मेमोरेंडम इश्यूड बाई माई मिनिस्ट्री एंड सर्कुलेटेड to honorable members. A further note explaining the various taxation proposals in greater detail was also subsequently circulated. I will not therefore weary the House by going into these provisions again and shall therefore dwell chiefly on the salient features of the amendments that were incorporated in the bill during its passage in the Lok Sabha. Sir, so far as personal taxation is concerned, the main emphasis of the critics has been against the lowering of the exemption limit on personal income tax and the reduction of the income tax burden on the higher slabs of income. On these points, I have been at pains to explain the objectives of our taxation policy. I had mentioned in my budget speech that the main reason for reduction in the existing rates at the higher levels of income was that in practice were very high rates of direct taxation at the top brackets of income tend to erode the tax base and encourage tax evasion. It is no doubt true that the maximum rate of income tax and super tax applicable to the top brackets of income is proposed to be reduced from about 92% to a little less than 77% for earned incomes and 84% for unearned incomes. But this reduction in marginal rates is not to be viewed in isolation. Under the tax pattern, income tax does not stand by itself. It is supplemented by the wealth tax and the expenditure tax. I have also pointed out on the floor of the Lok Sabha only recently, and I would like, if I may, to repeat here what I have stated there, that the integrated tax structure that has been proposed in the budget this year makes it necessary that the tax system should be broad-based. The existing exemption limit of ₹4,200 is an unduly large multiple of the average level of income in this country. This should be reduced to such a reasonable level as would widen the sphere of taxation and release the tax base from its present inelasticity. It is only reasonable that persons within the lower income brackets should also make their contributions, however small, to the state revenues. With development, more and more persons will come within the income groups which are now brought within the purview of income tax. Furthermore, with the income tax net cost wider, it will facilitate checking of tax evasion in the immediately higher brackets, which is a very important consideration so far as the lowering of the limits is concerned. Another amendment which I sponsored in the Lok Sabha for providing some relief and encouragement to the middle class investor relates to the increase in the normal surcharge exemption limit by the amount of dividends received on equity shares, subject to a maximum of ₹1,500. Sir, this has been brought in largely because of a complaint that has been made that the tax on companies would unduly affect, which I do not think it would. Nevertheless, the opinion is that it would unduly affect the position of the small investor in equity shares. Relief is sought to be given to him this way, that the cumulative effect would mean much greater relief than as if we made a refund of 0.5% to him of the company's tax collected. By another of my amendments to the bill, the additional surcharge of 15% on unearned income has been separated from the other two surcharges in order to put it beyond doubt that the proceeds from the former, namely the surcharge on unearned income, will form part of the divisible pool in which the states are to participate. This was the original intention, and it was felt that the divisible pool would not be affected. But certain queries were raised by the chief ministers of various states, and the law ministry felt that the position was somewhat nebulous, and so we thought we would make the position clear. There is another important amendment which I would like to mention.